Hello, I am Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about coordinate systems graphing. This is part two, so we've already done some of this. In the last one, I gave you one half of the ordered pair, and you had to find the other half. And now it's harder because I'm not giving you anything. I'm asking you to find three ordered pairs on your own, then plot them on a graph, and then think of a scenario that could fit this particular equation. Okay, so the first thing, we're going to find three ordered pairs. And so I'm going to put that into this table format that we saw before, but you can also just skip that and write them as ordered pairs. Sometimes people find this to be a little more useful, having it in the XY format. Okay, whenever my equation is in this format with y by itself, I am going to pick three values for x because it's easier for me to plug in for x and then just simplify this side. And the easiest one of all is always 0. What if x is 0? Because that makes that term drop out. So I'm picking three ordered pairs based on what is going to be easier for me. The next one that I see students do a lot is picking one, which is fine. You can definitely get an answer that works. But if you pick one times one half, you're going to have a fraction, and you're going to have to deal with fractions. So for me, being the lazy person that I am, I want to pick a number that would come out to be a nice number. So one doesn't work, but two would, right? Because I know half of two would be easy for me to do. So I'm going to pick two. And the next one then, if students get on that idea, is say, oh, I'm going to pick four, because half of four would also be easy, and that would be a perfectly acceptable thing also. But because I'm a math teacher and trying to show you a little more of the world, I'm going to pick a negative 2. Also will be easy to work with, but it's just a negative. If you pick 0, 2, and 4, or you pick 0, 1, and 2, it's going to work out. There's an infinite number of solutions. You have the freedom to choose your points. These are the points that I chose. If you like to choose your own and go graph and then come back and see if yours matches mine, that would be great practice. Okay. Now I'm going to plot these on a graph, but I have to find the other half of my ordered pairs. So I'm going to say, okay, what is y if x is 0? I'm plugging that in. You might be able to just by the cover-up method see that that term drops out and y is 3. If x is 0, I don't go left or right, I go up to 3. Again, you can number your graphs if that's helpful or if you need to. All right, so now what if x is 2? Well, I have half of 2 plus 3. Well, half of 2 is 1, so I get y is 1 plus 3, or 4. That's my second point. 2 over 1, 2, 3, 4 up. Okay. What about the third point? Well, my third point that I chose was negative 2. 1 half times negative 2 plus 3. Well, half of 2 is 1, but a negative times a positive is negative, so that's negative 1. And you can always do that on your calculator. You don't have to do everything in your head. Use your calculator to get past those kind of stumbling blocks that you may have. Negative 1 and positive 3 is 2, and so we get 2. Okay, then that point looks like negative 2, positive 2. So what I want to do when I plot those on a graph before I connect them up is say, did they form a line? Because this should form a line. Now remember that you picked three points, maybe not the same ones I picked, but your graph should look the same after you graph it, especially if you're doing what I'm telling you and extending through the points, not just making a tiny little thing connecting just your points, but extend a little ways and put arrows on the end. What if you had chosen the point 4? If you had chosen the point 4, your y would have been 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You would have had a point that's right up here, still on the same line. You just wouldn't have had this point back here. But you extend through a ways, and then you can see what the line would actually look like. Now, okay, part C, that was plotting them on a graph and connecting them up, making your line. A line is a picture of the solutions. All the points on that line are solutions to that equation. Okay, the next piece is to think of a scenario. And what I'm trying to do is get you to ground in your mind what something like this means. This number at the end is some kind of starting point. And this number is some kind of change that's happening over time or over whatever. So over something. Time is the most useful one that we usually talk about. It could be happening over distance or whatever. Okay, so what's a scenario that somebody could start with 3 of something and then see a change of 1/2 happening periodically? If you thought of something fantastic, here's my scenario for this. My hair was 3 inches long, and then it grew 1/2 every month. Or your hair was 3 inches long. Somebody's hair was 3 inches long. Does that make sense for our picture? Look what if I looked at this time as 0, no time has passed at all. I have 3-inch long hair. That is my starting point. And then every month it's getting longer. And that is typically what happens with hair. And so it makes sense that we're getting longer or going up as time goes on. We're going to get longer and longer and longer hair. Because this is positive, I'm going to be growing hair over time. Okay, if I started with 3 inches and started cutting or had a negative 1/2, every month I cut a half off, I would see my hair length going down, right? That makes sense. The up and down have to do with whether you're getting a positive change or a negative change going on. Okay, you should really try to do this one on your own and then come back and check in. I'm going to find 3 ordered pairs. Notice that this one doesn't have, this one was Y was by itself, and this one, the X and Y are together. This is a different format, but we can still do the same thing. But when I have this format, what I find to be easiest, because I get to choose my points and I can choose whatever I want. I don't know why I can't draw a table, but that's awful. Anyway, I always choose, what if Y was 0, what if X was 0? I always do those 0 points because those are important points that we'll talk about in the next videos, actually, coming up. And then I say I have to choose one more just for a checkpoint. I'm going to choose what if X was 1. So there's my 3 points that I'm going to pick. I pick those randomly, and if things don't work out, I can choose something different. Okay. What if X is 0? Do you see that 2 times 0 would just go away? If you can see that, you can save yourself a little time. 2 times 0 minus Y. Don't forget that you have a negative Y, and so you have to divide both sides by negative 1, and Y is negative 4. And my terrible little table can only even fit my values. Okay, the next one, what if Y is 0? Can you see that the Y would just drop out here? If you can save yourself this step. And then you can divide both sides by 2, and X is 2. And then my third point, I said, what if X was 1? So I'm going to do 2 times 1 minus Y is 4. 2 minus Y is 4. And I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides. Negative Y is 2, and Y is negative 2. Yes, I did that pretty quickly. That's because you already did it off camera before and don't need all that time on it. That's something you've learned before, how to plug in and simplify or solve an equation. So I'm not spending a ton of time on that. Okay, my first point, 0. Don't go left or right. Go down 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 0, negative 4. My second point, go 2 to the right, and then don't go up or down, because y is 0, sorry. And then my third point, 1, negative 2, over 1, down 2. And I can rejoice in the fact that my 3 points did form a line. That's a nice check to make sure that they all worked. And then when I connect those points, I have the graph of my equation. It's a little harder to come up with scenarios that fit in this format. So we're going to work on scenarios that fit this type. So don't worry about a scenario there. We could come up with something, but I'm going to work on the other type of scenario, the other formula type, and that is, what about this one, the last one, for y equals x, Find three ordered pairs and graph. So this is one that students balk at a little bit because they're like, whoa, it looks totally different. I don't know what to do. Let's just start the process for a second and see what happens. Maybe I won't even try to make a box here, just lines. What if x was, in this format, I like to choose x values. What if x was 0? What if x was 1? What if x was negative 1? What this equation says is that x equals y. So if I plug in, what if x is 0, I get y is 0. I plug in, what if x was 1, then y is 1. I plug in, what if x was negative 1, then y is negative 1. All that says is that they equal each other. That's it. Okay, so basically in this one, I don't see it, but I have like a 0 starting point. In other words, I started with nothing. So when you have nothing, you don't bother to write the plus 0, but I could have. This is somebody who started with nothing. And what's the number in front of this x when we don't see it? 1. So you're new to the job. You start with nothing and you start gaining 1 customer per month or 1 customer per phone call or whatever the x is. But that's something that could happen is that you start with 0. In fact, most of us when we start a new job, that's kind of where we come in, right? And this one, even though we don't see it, has this little 1 in front. So we're gaining 1 per month of something. But our 3 points, 0, 0, 1, 1, negative 1, negative 1, form a line. And then if we connect up those points, we have this equation. This is a pretty famous equation, you know, that we see. And this is somebody who's gaining customers every month or whatever, and so it's going up. It's a positive thing that's happening because we have a positive one. We're going up every month. Okay, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.